那接下来我们剩下的时间做简单的，还有一点时间可以做提问跟交流。那想请问在场的各位有没有什么任何问题对三位讲者想要提问的？有吗？高武。
Slido 上面有一些问题。
对，先生。
还是我把它接上去。
好，现在放下去，太好了。像我那么害羞的人，真的不知道怎么主持。其实有准备
了，
我有准备问题。
Moderator,
像我这种既害羞又专业的主持人，好、哦、哇，第一个点名，十号兄，
好，我看到
有没有点到？
好，
好，
这个你要做的
是好。
OK， 有一个 repo 他是有写错，巴拉巴拉，本质上选址，嗯，对啊，没错，就是有限制，没错。例如，不用电脑画油画，天，嗯，对，所以这边是有画油画的朋友吗？
我会画油画，
我高中就有画油画了，对，好，就像数位摄影绝对不同意，没错，没错，那就是一个，2015年的时候尝试实体的一个美材嘛，然后那时候因为也就没有什么人参与，所以2018年就想说来尝试一个数位美材，所以同样问题就可以问在2015年，就是那这样子想要写成诗人是不是就没有办法参加2015年的展览？没错，就是这样子，所以就是其实我觉得美材的确是展览，我们做展览都很常在想美材问题嘛，对吧 ？Bass， 那这个时候就是怎么讲？很难讲，就是我决定这个展览长什么样子，可是也不一定要我决定啊。如果更多人参与，就大家都可以一起决定。OK， 那也许一个网站也可以加上跟油画有关的东西，那就是靠大家一起来决定说怎么样代表这个社群做一个展览。所先天上，所以我的意思就是说，每个选择都有它排除的，跟它就是对有些人比较容易参与，对有些人比较难参与。那在这边距离力就是数位上的、科技上的，大家比较容易参与；那其他的大家比较不容易参与，所以就是每个选择都是的确是有它的牺牲，没错。谢谢指教。
我这边顺便插一个问题啊，因为刚好顺着志浩兄，那其实因为我自己在有在经营 Makerspace， 经营 Maker 社群，那志浩在处理的事情就是曾经我想要做过的事情，可是因为想要。种种的现实的一些限制，还有基本上个人比较胆小，没有勇气的关系，就也没有做。因为最难处理的就是把数位虚拟的东西、社群的东西搬到现实。那之后那时候在台北数位艺术节弄了这样的，就是跟大家一起社群去弄那样整个展览。后续的发展其实我都一直在关心。其实我看的是某种程度是很难过啦，因为就是怎么就是觉得怎么不可以让圈外人来展，我觉得这件事就狠狠的被打了一棍，所以我在想这件事如果再来一次，反正是有多重领域的概念嘛，因为做多重宇宙概念，如果再来一次，你会再怎么去处理这件事情？
再来一次的话，我就会拒绝展，然后。我觉得说，如果社群真的有够多的朋友愿意想要用展览的形式来探讨城市居民，那我们就一起来讨论，然后一起长期的经营一个，也许是一个长期的空间的一个展览，就不要再去迎合那些什么奇怪的奖啊、奇怪的这些 talk 啊。我觉得那其实还好，没什么太大意义，因为社群自己也知道自己在做什么，其实不太就是对这样。所以如果有兴趣的话，就是大家可以一起来聊天，然后一起长期的经营某个东西，这样会更有意义。
好，谢谢。
就像红旗做的那个 Open Lab，
对吧？对啊，常常迈入历史。OK， 好，那第二个问题，这个对，这个要什么？对，
我开放，还是？
对。
好，
所以中文就是因为我们是台湾人嘛，那台湾突然跳到第三个问题，很尴尬。有什么台湾政府可以帮忙那个图博做的事情吗？
对 ，So it's now
the third one.
Okay, so I cannot speak for the Taiwanese government, honestly. But then, in my talk, I mentioned about the lack of training and lack of resources. So the fact that the GovSeal Summit, the committee has accepted my talk, and it did allow me this platform to share my story, to meet with a lot of other people networking. So so the lack of, so in terms of training and then in terms of resources, when I mean that lack of resources in terms of human resources, exchanging and then, helping and then bridging the gap that that both parties have, I think that would be one, or that would be the first key steps towards it. But I can't speak for the time is gone, sorry.
Maybe, because I asked the question.
Oh, you asked the question?
Yeah, I asked the question, and maybe it's like, as a Tibetan, what do you think would be good that, because I'm a Taiwanese, and what I can do is push my government to help with the Tibetan situation, and that's why I asked the question, like, what would you think, like, what do you need, and then what can we give you, sort of? Or do you think that's not what you want?
But I think at the moment, so those two things that I mentioned before, lack of training and lack of resources,
mm-hmm.
So resources in terms of human, resources in terms of products, technology. So these things, there are so many communities that I know, the only three communities that I know so far, the Fedora community, the Gov Summit, and then the GNOME community. Three that I'm meeting with them later this conference. But then I'm sure there's so many other communities that that would be willing to collaborate and then help the Tibetan government and the Tibetan community. So meeting those people, and then exchanging, and then the knowledge and the resources would be really helpful.
Should we follow up with the next question?
Yeah, so can you give us an example of a tag that you or your friends received? The second question.
So the most common attacks that the Tibetan community receive, as I've said before, is phishing attacks, right? Pretending to be somebody when it's actually not. And then and there are so many, the examples that I've used in my talk, like Topic Trooper or the Oil Red Alpha, all of these are the kind of examples that the Tibetan community are being targeted with phishing attack, the social engineering attack. And once they have bought the attack and then click on the link, they are provided with that custom malware. So how can you resolve it, right? So it's really, really important for you to educate yourself, for example, and then ask. I would want to use a very funny reference in Buddhism, have no attachments. In terms of it's really important for us when you are part of such community that receive a lot of attacks, it's just like ask your questions are you expecting such attachments? Think before clicking on link. So these are small, basic security simple measures that will save you from getting the attack itself. But I don't think that you can actually stop an attack, but then you can, choose not to open a link or choose not to click the link.
以一位人类学家的生命角度，想请问在最近，如果想以人类学做些什么，有没有什么经验或是案例可以分享？
我觉得人类学某个程度上是一个非常反思性的学科，然后它有很多 skill， 那个 skill 是跟人说话、沟通，然后去了解事情从不同的面向。那其实科技圈尤其是在就是 Jenny 里面，其实比较强调资料、数据。那我觉得人类学其实某个程度上可以捕捉那个面向，就是有一些资料它背后还有很多不同面向的故事，然后这种叫 soft 的部分是可以捕捉一种。那实际上我没有办法很明确指出什么案例哦，因为其实这样子的角色不只是人类学家，所有做文字工作者，然后社工不同领域的人，其实也都有这样的技能。所以其实，在不同的人的专业专案里面，都有类似的角色跟所谓的 coder 一起协作，然后再把一个专案做到最好。那只是我们希望可以汇聚更多不同像这样子领域的人。
由于时间关系，那我们这场就到这边。然后谢谢四位讲者以及各位的参与，谢谢各位。